Welcome back, Guardian. Thanks for tuning in. So it doesn't matter if you have the 1.0 Enhanced Impact Induction or 1.0 Regular Impact Induction, it works the same as the 2.0 versions, same as traction and things like that. They all work the same. Just because they're a 2.0 version doesn't mean they're different from the 1.0 version, if that makes sense. But then I started testing Enhanced Momentum Transfer and Regular Momentum Transfer, and I wanted to get that video out first because Enhanced Momentum Transfer is broken right now and not for the good. To save time on this video, I'm just going to call out numbers for the tiers and things like that so you're not bored to death waiting with the stopwatch with me. But we're going to start it at tier 4. That's a stock minute and 8 charge time. I'm going to be using the Armor 2.0 Momentum Transfer, which is exactly the same as the Armor 1.0 Momentum Transfer. And we'll see what the charge time comes out to. Before Shadowkeep launched, it never mattered how many melee mods you had on. It was always 4 seconds off with regular Momentum Transfer, and it would give you 8 seconds off if you had the enhanced version of Momentum Transfer. So we're going to test it at tier 4 right now. That's a minute and 8 charge time stock. But regular Momentum Transfer actually got a 2 second buff compared to 1.0 before Shadowkeep, and now gets 6 seconds off, so a minute and 2 from a minute and 8. However, when you get to different tiers such as tier 2, tier 1, it'll take 8 seconds off. That's the same thing with tier 3 as well. So the lower your tier, the more that it gives you off of your melee. Then if you get up to tier 8 or tier 9 or tier 7, it starts giving you 3 seconds off every time you hit a momentum transfer with somebody. So 7 up is a 3 seconds off. Tiers 4 through 6 grant 6 seconds off. And with tiers 1, 2, and 3, you get 8 seconds off when you throw a grenade against an enemy's body. So that's how it kind of changes depending on what tier that you're on. Now what we're going to do is put on Enhanced Momentum Transfer that will work the same as you have the 1.0 or the 2.0 version, and I'm going to explain why it's broken. So tiers 1 through 3 was 8 seconds with regular, it only gives you 6 seconds with enhanced. Tiers 4 through 6 gives you 4 seconds instead of 6 seconds. And tiers 7 through 10 only grants 2 seconds off from 3 seconds off. So Enhanced Momentum Transfer, I don't know if Bungie knows this, but it doesn't function right now. So if you have the regular versions, don't use the enhanced versions. I also did a test to see if you could put 2 regular momentum transfers on your 2.0 arms because it has 2 slots where you can socket in 2 of those. They don't stack, so don't use 2 of them. It doesn't act like you have, you know, enhanced versions or anything and give you double the benefit. If you put 1 on, it's the same as putting 2 on, so don't waste your energy points trying to stack those. That goes for impact induction as well. You can't stack 2 of those and get double the benefit. So only use 1 and use something else in your slot, which we're going to talk about that more in depth as I keep going through these builds. Based on the charge rates Momentum Transfer even offers, I actually don't recommend anybody using Momentum Transfer. Now that I know the data and the testing on it, I'd much rather do Impact Induction or Enhanced Impact Induction, which we will go over that in depth on the next video, but I wanted to get this information out in case anybody's trying to stack Momentum Transfer times 2 on their 2.0 arms, or if you're using your 1.0 Enhanced versions or the 2.0 Enhanced versions. Just to let you know that they don't stack right now. But once I figure out enough data to start putting actual builds together towards like the end game stuff, I'll go over more exotic and charge times off based on momentum transfer and enhanced impact induction and things like that. But I wanted to keep this video simple to just explain the natural charge times and reductions off that they offer you right now. I don't really want to overcomplicate this and, you know, tell you when you have, you know, Nezric Sin on or Crown of Tempest, it does this and that, or when you have Doomfangs on, this happens, or there's a lot of things that can get involved in this. I didn't want to make it so complicated that it's like, what did he just say, you know? So when we actually get to where I'm putting actual builds together, I'll put all the pieces together mixed with whatever exotic I'll be using, and we'll go over all the details at that time. The next video is going to cover impact induction and enhanced impact induction. It also changes, but it's a lot more in-depth and confusing because some melees will take off more than another melee depending on what tier you're on. So 4 melees may have 4 different reductions in time. It gets really confusing, so I had to break that off into a separate video and also figure out how to make that more entertaining besides me sitting with a stopwatch and explaining it. So I'll do my best that I can with that video. Good luck in Iron Banner 2, dropping a lot of enhanced perks this week, so take advantage while it lasts. If you want to hit me up at teespring.com/Rostophilus to shop and support the channel, also at paypal.me/Rostophilus, or you can join the Beast Squad, become the ultimate supporter. I highly appreciate all of you viewers, all of you who share the videos. Hit subscribe if you want to, it's up to you, but I will see you all bros on the next video, next time.
In space.